The controversial Dabhol power project was back in the news when the US multinational Enron Corporation announced that it was restarting arbitration proceedings in London this week. This followed the failure of the Maharashtra government to convey its decision on renegotiation of the project before the stipulated deadline of the 10th of December 1995. Reacting to this, the Shiv Sena chief, Mr. Bal Thackeray, has threatened to scrap the Dabhol power project if Enron tries to put pressure on the Maharashtra government.
Yogesh Chander Deveshwar, presently the vice chairman in ITC, is to take over as the next chairman of the Indian corporate giant, the ₹47 billion or $1.38 billion ITC group, as KL Chugh, the outgoing chairman, relinquishes charge on 31st December this year. Following a series of hectic meetings at Virginia House, the corporate headquarters of ITC in Calcutta, the representatives of London-based Bat Industries, which is the largest single shareholder in ITC with over 30% shares in the group, the five Indian financial institutions which hold nearly 38% stake in the ITC group, and the board members of ITC gave the final approval to Deveshwar's nomination as chairman. Vice Deveshwar, who joined ITC way back in 1968 as management pupil, has also served Air India as chairman and managing director between 1991 to 1994.
The Indian healthcare sector got a shot in the arm with the launch of the hospital with hospitality in the capital this week. Part of the Apollo chain of hospitals, the joint sector Indraprastha Apollo Hospital, covering a total built-up area of 600,000 square feet, has on offer over 50 super specialities.
The hospitals of this standard can do a significant difference in the economy of our country. Number one, people don't have to go abroad. You know, the facilities that we are giving are the same that they would get anywhere in the world, and at a fraction of the cost in their doorstep.
The state-of-the-art facilities offered include sleep laboratory, radiology, cardiothoracic surgery, neurology, and Asia's only bloodless X-knife neurosurgery. Here was something for anybody in search of a comfortable home, eco-friendly lifestyle and aesthetic decor. Inside Outside Mega Show, which opened this week in the capital, opened sesame to a comprehensive spectrum of building materials, construction equipment, interior decoration and furnishing.